They were a hockey team on the way to a playoff game. They were wings and centers, defensemen and goalies, coaches, trainers, and broadcasters. They were sons and brothers, and they were teammates and friends. Many were teenagers, chasing a hockey dream far from home. They were the Humboldt Broncos. It was a year ago, late on the afternoon of April 6th, when the Broncos team bus collided with a truck that had run a stop sign at a rural intersection in Saskatchewan. 14 were killed, 2 would die later, 13 were injured. It was an unspeakable tragedy. There would be no playoff game. A sport had been brought to its knees. For nearly half a century, the Broncos had been the beating heart of Humboldt. The town would fill the rink to watch them play. Now they filled the rink with flowers and other memorials to remember their lives. Because hockey is not just a game, not in Canada, and not anywhere that little boys and girls skate in cold indoor rinks in the morning and on frozen ponds in the afternoon. Hockey is a way of life. Around the world, the sport opened its arms. Sticks were left outside front doors, a show of solidarity with the Broncos and with hockey families everywhere. Families that would understand in ways that others could not. A GoFundMe campaign launched after the crash raised more than $15 million for the families of those lost or injured. The Humboldt Strong Community Foundation took over and raised $4 million more. The money has paid for funerals, for medical needs, and for scholarships. And it will continue. News that organs donated by Broncos 21-year-old defenseman Logan Boulay had saved 6 lives triggered a nationwide surge in signups for organ donation. It came to be called the Logan Effect. There is no going back and no erasing the pain, no restoring those lost. But survivors have battled. Some return to the ice in other places. Some return to the ice in other ways. One met his hero. 333 days after the crash, the last hospitalized survivor was released. 18 days later, the truck driver was sentenced to 8 years in prison. And the Broncos were rebuilt. Tryouts assembled a new roster. A coach was found and then resigned. An assistant replaced him and stayed. 2 players who were on the bus rejoined the team. Braden Camrude and Derek Patter. The Broncos made the playoffs and lost a tough 7-game series. Again, the Humboldt Rink was home for a town and a team. Because hockey lives on, and hockey heals, and hockey will never forget.